Elden Ring is looking like being one of the more remarkable games of 2022, transplanting the signature FromSoft game design ethos into a huge open world. But how does it perform on one of the more remarkable graphics cards of 2015? Elden Ring's minimum requirements aren't too heavy by modern AAA gaming standards. The graphics cards recommended are the GTX 1060 3GB or RX 580 4GB, so 980 Ti owners should be able to look at this with a fair degree of confidence that they can get at least a playable frame rate. I'll be testing this out on my moderately priced gaming PC, equipped with an overclocked 6-core 12-thread Ryzen 5 5600G, with 16GB of DDR4 3600 RAM, so depending on your own system specs, your mileage may vary. Unlike a lot of my benchmarking videos, in this one I'm starting off aiming for the 60fps cap. Elden Ring has no option to turn off this limitation, and as far as I know, the mods to remove it also require the game to be played offline, and I'm not that desperate to know how high the FPS can actually go. At 1920x1080 I started conservatively, testing out the medium preset and saw that it could play at close to a locked 60fps. It's a little below this because at the time of writing the game still has a few shader compilation issues that cause minor frame time spikes, and although these appear to have improved, they haven't gone away altogether. FromSoft apparently aren't known for fixing these kinds of bugs, so I'm going to go out on a limb and say there's probably not a lot you can do about them. Medium's a place to start, but I wouldn't want to live there. Selecting the high preset smartens up the visuals considerably at remarkably little cost to frame rates. 1% lows drop a couple of frames, but on the whole, this is virtually indistinguishable from medium and should be a no-brainer choice for 980 Ti owners. The adventurous among you, however, might want to see how things fare at the maximum preset. Alas, this is where I've lost my nice, smooth, near 60fps experience. Drops were much more frequent and severe, down into the 40s, bringing the average FPS down to 55. This is absolutely a tolerable experience, and I dare say many people might never even notice the difference. If you're a Soulsborne diehard, however, this might throw off your dodges and parries, so you'll probably want to stick to high. With this much performance at hand, it made me wonder how much was being left on the table by the FPS cap. To test this, I used DSR, or Dynamic Super Resolution, to run the game at 2560x1440. Starting once more at the medium preset, and performance is close to 1080 at maximum, averaging 55 and dropping into the 40s. This isn't really going to please anyone. A simple gain in pixels can't make up for the overall reduction in image quality from running at medium, and the frame rate drop will cause gameplay issues for those looking to make split-second reactions. For the latter, the advice is simple, stick to 1080 high or below. For the former, there's still some settings to try. 1440 high falls a little short of 50fps on average, with 1% lows in the 30s, and you might be thinking that this would be the ideal setting for adding a custom 30fps cap in nVidia Control Panel or Reaver Tuner. But you'd be wrong. That's because stepping up to 1440 maximum still doesn't drop below 30, with averages of 44. In that case, providing you're okay with 30fps, 1440 maximum should still give a highly playable experience. But why stop there? After all, the 980 Ti was a 4K capable card in its day. Let's see how it's holding up. I decided on a cautious start at 3840x2160 low. This came out better than I might have thought, managing a 45fps average and 35fps 1% low. Of course, pixels aside, it looks atrocious, the low-res shadow maps in particular looking decidedly nasty. Medium doesn't improve quality a whole lot either, but it does eat up a whopping 10fps from the average and 6fps from the 1% lows. If 30fps minimums are your red line for playability, this might be as far as you want to proceed. Further down the rabbit hole, however, there are still two more quality settings to choose. 4K high could prove to be this card's undoing, with an average only scraping over 30fps and cinematic 1% lows. It's been an impressive showing, but surely the poor old card can't take much more of this. Well, giving up now wouldn't be the Soulsborne way, so I took one last stab at 2160 maximum. Averages don't take too much of a dent, and neither do 1% lows, but alas, this is the straw that breaks the camel's back. You see, Elden Ring reaches a point where it just gives up trying to draw stuff if you don't have enough GPU horsepower, and this can be quite inconvenient. The enemy that's stabbing you might have suddenly turned invisible, but the damage they're doing to your health bar is quite real. The 980 Ti struggled valiantly to the bitter end, and I think Nvidia can be proud of how it fared against a pretty tough challenger in 2022. For more examples of how the 980 Ti is holding up in the latest games, check out my review video linked on screen now. Kindly do the usual YouTube things if you feel so inclined, and I'll see you next time.